Welcome back to the channel. I'd like to share some good news. As you can see, I recently passed the OSCP exam. Therefore, I decided to share a video with the audience of YouTube to motivate the new learners, or at least people that are still like thinking about, am I ready for the exam or not? This is the video that you should see, and maybe I can boost you some motivation or whatever. So in general, I decided to take this exam because I wanted to enhance my skill, but at the same time target other certification from Offsec. So I think OSCP is a milestone for sure, no doubt, but it's not the only thing that you need to focus on. I mean, in general, this certification is quite useful because it gives you a lot of knowledge, broad knowledge from a different point of view. But I think the main point of Offsec is that we want to, in general, make you understand what system you have in front of you and go beyond that, like with Google search or external resources, external tools, and also a try harder methodology, which will allow you to really solve these machines and improve in life and improve in your job. Now, let's spend some time on the study techniques and suggestion. As you can see, during the course, you will have suggestion by Offsec to use Obsidian. Obsidian is a nice tool, a visual editor for Markdown language, aka MD. This editor is quite useful because it will allow you to create a good structure of notes, and you can really edit the visual, which means that it will be useful to read. And I think in general, having a good Obsidian note, which means having a good cheat sheet, you will definitely have a good armory, and you will definitely able to perform assessment also offline, because I think more time you will spend in this part and more time you will spend in the offensive security learning phase, and you will have maybe sometime a better local Google search engine than the Google itself in a strict scenario. I also want to share some tips about always making tooling research about the tool that you are seeing, and also what kind of variant there are on tools, because in general, all the tools showed in the OSCP will work in the machines of the exam. But it's always good to have a variation, or at least some open source tooling that you can find in the Discord channel of Offsec, which is already connected to your learning subscription for the OSCP PEN 200. So there you can find a lot of things in terms of challenges, in terms of tooling, whenever you are blocked. And during the study part, I suggest to spend a lot of time to get the 10 bonus points. Not just because this 10 bonus point can allow you to pass the exam, but at the same time, the 10 bonus point can allow you to really understand deeply the purpose of the course and what Offsec is trying to teach you through the PEN 200. Now, let's talk about the training material. As we can see here, we will have different topics. The first four are, in general, an introduction of the course. And at the same time, Offsec want to show you the different kind of career path that you can achieve during this Offsec learning phase. At the same time, there are some good topics about how to improve on study methodology and how to really take notes efficiently. Next, we have the report writing and penetration tester, where definitely, as you can see from the title, is the reporting module, where in general, in your job, in bug bounty or whatever kind of thing you are doing, even a scientific research, the report is the key thing. If you're not able to write it decently and structure it decently, you will not be evaluated, or at least it seems that you are not good on doing your job. So really spend a lot of time there and try to really understand how to describe step by step what you were trying to achieve. Even if you were unable, because sometimes I heard around that you can really fail the exam just for the report, because if you're not able to describe the attack chain with sequential image or sequential structure words, you will be failed. Next, let's talk about information gathering, vulnerability scanning. These two topics are quite interesting to really understand the and make you aware about how to proceed in terms of, you will find something, I don't know, you will find a web application, you will find a service, what kind of steps you need to do, you will find a company, you need to target a company, what kind of research you should do and how you can leverage Google or how you can do whatever you like. Common Web Application Attack, SQL injection attacks. Already know, I think in general, that there are different resources where you can learn web application attacks. I think these ones are enough to target the OSCP exam. You need to study them carefully. Not all of them, maybe they're super feasible with the exam, but as you can imagine, yeah, any success need to have on the system at least a user that is triggering it, or at least an automated process. So in general, these are behavior that are not present in the OSCP, but you never know. Client-side attacks, here really you will find good resources, maybe more oriented towards OSCP, OffSec Expert Professional, because as you can read here, client-side attacks need to have need to be triggered from the client. So in general, you need to have a human end or an automated process. Locating public exploit, a fixing exploit. This is a key thing for the exam. Spend a lot of time here. Try to understand what OffSec is trying to show you, what kind of methodology you need to use in terms of searching an exploit, adjusting the exploit, and understand what you are running. Because remember, we are not script kiddie, and in general, script kiddie are always creating not just problem for the world, but also for themselves, because they're not able to understand what kind of risk they are going through. At the same time, what kind of disruption they are creating. Other topics, we can see antivirus evasion is really interesting. Maybe not strictly necessary for the OSCP, but more for the OSEP. Password attacks, spend a lot of time here. You will find a lot of good resources, forcing methodology, intelligence brute forcing methodology, and so on. Windows privilege escalation, Linux privilege escalation. I think they are quite clear what these topics are there for, because you will find a way to privilege escalate yourself in most of the machine, or you need to, because to get 20 points, at first you will have an initial access, and you will get one user, 10 points. If you want to get the other 10 points, you need to privilege escalate if you're in a Windows machine or in a Linux machine. Following the lesson shared here, but at the same time go also for external resources, and that we will talk about that, because you will enjoy more the process without being stuck and being worried. Power redirection and SSH tunneling through deep packet expansion. Here, definitely, if you have already a previous background knowledge about tunneling, spend anyway time here, or you will easily understand it. If you are stuck, try to spend time, go to external resources, use external tools like legalo-ng, which will be shown after in the other slides. Metasploit framework, I think most of you that are listening to this video know what is Metasploit, but here you will find some good introduction and good space explanation. Now, Active Directory introduction enumeration, attacking Active Directory identification and lateral movement in Active Directory. Since 2022 material and 2023, Active Directory was introduced in the exam, and the boxes which consist in three machines are evaluated 40 points, and you can get these 40 points just if you're able to exploit all the three machines. So as you can understand, spend a lot of time here and try to go through external resources, because they will be helpful and game changer for you. The last two topics are more a recap and an introduction to the challenges labs, because as we can see in this other slide, you will have machines to do. MedTech and Relia are quite useful, and really 1.1 to what you can find in the OSCP exam. Skylark is quite interesting, but at the same time, you will spend more time here if you are targeting more OSCP boxes, because it's quite big. But spend a lot of time in challenge 4, 5, and 6, OSCP A, B, C, because here are like old boxes, old exam structure that has Active Directory and independent machine, in which you can spend a lot of time. And if you are stuck, you can go on Discord and try to find some ints, but I always suggest to go through the box alone if your stock going through a write-up or whatever, and gradually proceed to the solution without really just reading it, and remove enjoyment of proceeding with your brain, proceeding with your intuition or whatever. Is this enough for the exam? Yes, but I think you need to at least spend more time in additional resources. For example, here we can see that OffSec provide a subscription on providing ground practice, where you will find a lot of boxes that are quite similar to OSCP boxes. I really suggest to use this resource in NetSec Focus Trophy Room. I will share the link on the description and maybe in the video if you do allow me. You will learn here Windows and Linux privilege escalation, and this kind of knowledge can be merged to with the knowledge of the course. Is this enough? Yes, but Active Directory. Active Directory, I think in general, if you feel that you're ready and you already have a good understanding of Active Directory due to your work or due to whatever kind of other activity you were doing, you can skip this part, but I really suggest to spend some time on TryAcme and try to go through the course and try to understand deeply Active Directory. If you really want to upgrade your learning phase, try to create an instance of on your virtual machine or whatever you want to try to create an Active Directory and see. But this is more a reverse engineering thing. But if you have a lot of time, try to do this and you will understand a lot of vulnerabilities and really the risk that can create these vulnerabilities. Because in general, most of the time, if you just do the labs, you will not understand really what kind of risk OffSec or at the same time other kind of provider are trying to show you. I like to share also my GitHub repository. Here you will not find any kind of hints of the exam, but at the same time, you can take a look once you finish the PEN 200 course, or at the same time, you want to, see what kind of tools I had at the air. I think not all the tools are strictly necessary, but take a look there. And also Legalo-NG is quite useful for pivoting and tunneling. Xenspan to create more virtual instance to compile exploit. But again, I think I went too deep into the material, external material. So you can find some good, interesting thing, but maybe on the shelves. On the shell, you will find a lot of good shells. So spend some time there if you want. Now let's talk about the exam. The exam provides you with three independent targets. These targets get the points. You need to follow this kind of procedure. Find an initial access. You will get 10 points with a normal user or a normal service. And from there, you need to privilege escalate to the admin, administrator in Windows, and root in Linux. This kind of points, you can get 10 points for one machine, even if you're not able to get the admin, or 20 points here if you're able to get both of them. On the other side, there is the Active Directory box, which will be evaluated 40 points. Spend initially a lot of time there. To get the 40 bonus points, you need to exploit all the chain of the domain. So therefore, you will have two clients and one domain controller, and you need to really exploit them completely to get the 40 bonus points. And I suggest to spend time initially here, because in general, what a lot of people do, they will target the Active Directory box. If they're stuck, they will jump to independent machine. But I think in general, if you're able to get the 40 points, you will boost a lot of confidence. And I think you will smash the other machine, or in general, you will get the necessary points. Because as we can see here, the 70 points are the minimum that are required to get the exam. It's possible to get to 100 points in total plus the 10 bonus points, so 110. As you can see here, I created another slide about reporting. I really think that we need to focus a lot on reporting, and there are templates available by OffSec in which you can really just adjust the structure and start to report there. I suggest to report continuously while you're doing the exam. I did the same, but I used mostly Obsidian. So it depends on your choice, but at least while you finish a box or while you're doing a box or at the end of the Active Directory, try to see if all the steps are present, and at the same time you have all the screens of the flags. See, there is another tool that I'm sharing here, Autoregon made by Tiberius. It's quite interesting to enumerate a single machine and multiple machine, but in general, rely to your own tools. This is useful because if you run this tool, you will have a folder structured that is really useful to take notes or at least add an exploit or add an inscription. At the same time, you can use Obsidian to work directly on those. We are at the end. I hope I was able to motivate you a little bit. I was able to share some good tools. And in general, I think this is not a sprint, it's a marathon. So try to spend a lot of time here and try to understand if you're ready or not. Try to go to external resources. Try to spend time on Discord. And during the exam, if you're stuck or whatever, take breaks, walk around your neighborhood, go to buy something in the supermarket, and try to really talk with a friend, talk with someone, because it's useful to understand that if you are in a bubble, if you're stuck, you need to go outside, or at least you need to go different thing that make you go out your comfort zone, or at least your concentration zone, because most of the time you can be stuck and you are not able to see the road that OffSec would like to show you. So believe in yourself, take breaks, think straight, try harder. Thank you for the attention. See you in the future.